तो आपन जिते आपन को जो कैंडिडेट चेयर थी से चेयर पे पहुंचिबे तो जहां भी आपन डिसाइड करछन कि ग्रीट कर दिया पे नमस्कार गुड मॉर्निंग गुड इवनिंग आपन को मैं जो से देने से तो तब से कहले प्लीज बी सीट से कहला पर आपन बस प्लीज बी सीट थैंक यू सर प्लीज गिव अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन
सर आई एम वीरेंद्र त्रिपाठी आई हैव डन माय पोस्टग्रेजुएशन इन एमए इन एग्रीकल्चर इकोनॉमिक्स फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर ओयोटी and presently I am studying in Bhubaneswar.
Okay. तो ठीक अच्छे जी कहते हैं ठीक अच्छे एक्चुअली इंट्रोडक्शन पचार हमें अलरेडी जहाँ मुझे कहते क्या से ना पचार ना धरतु पचारे आम पांचटे जिन रहा नंबर वन नाटा कहते आई एम कि माइ नेम इज ओके बहुत जो माइ सेल्फ रू स्टार्ट करते भूल नंबर वन द्वितीय जिस कि आपणकर डोमिसाइल फर्स्ट सो आई एम सो एंड सो फ्रॉम ए डिस्ट्रिक्ट से आपर तापर आसा आपर हाइएस्ट क्वालिफिकेशन आई एम ए ग्रेजुएट और पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट जहाँ भी आप हाइएस्ट क्वालिफिकेशन इन ए पर्टिकुलर डिसिप्लिन फ्रॉम ए कॉलेज कहते करेंट स्टेटस प्रेजेंटली आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज कि आपने प्रेजेंटली आई एम डूइंग माय एमएससी इन एग्रीकल्चर and agricultural economics and I'm also preparing for civil services. So, I have hobbies and achievements. So, my hobbies are AI, if you have a hobby, then say that sentence. I have no hobbies, that I don't have any. Okay, so my hobbies are this and this. Okay, so that's hobbies and achievements. So, if you have a school record, you have an achievement, you have a college record. So, coming to my achievements, I have won AI prize. I have participated in this and that. Say that now, achievements. Achievements may be educational achievements. Achievements may be professional achievements. Essay debate, or paper present for change put together. Say this is something that I have done. It is an introduction. Now, bachelor how many prize? But upon ready, it is well. Try what you do. Introduction is done. Okay. So, can you tell me what is the meaning of your name, Virendra?
Sir, it has come from two words, that is Vira and Indra. So, basically it means the warrior, warriors, the bravest of warrior.
Okay, that is Virendra. So, this is your first attempt in the exam?
No sir, I have already attempted in the previous year, that is 2017.
Okay.
And I could not qualify for the mains.
Okay. So then, you have tried harder and this time you have qualified for the interview.
Yes sir.
Okay. So, what are your options?
Sir, my optional was agriculture and forestry.
Your BSc and MSc both are in agriculture from OUE?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what optionals you have taken?
Sir, agriculture and forestry.
Agriculture and forestry, okay. Agriculture is your domain, that is, I understand that. Why have you chosen forestry?
Sir, forestry is more or less related to agriculture. And the concepts are equally applicable to the agricultural crops as well. And I found it very interesting to study, and it is also a scoring optional. That's why I have chosen it.
Okay, that is why you have chosen. Okay, so you are doing your post graduation in agriculture. Okay, so. I mean, you could have served the nation more directly by joining as an agricultural officer or as a researcher, right? So, you are interested for civil services, if suppose you are selected for civil service. Don't you think that India will lose a manpower in agricultural research and in agricultural improvement because believe agriculture is the backbone of our economy. So what is your opinion on this?
Sir, I believe I can do better in the civil administration. Because agriculture, I could be an agriculture officer or an agriculture researcher or an agriculture professor. But here I can formulate better policies for the development of agriculture in a broader way.
Okay.
And the recent issues like farm loan issue, that I could have taken effectively if I joined civil administration.
Okay, that is fine. So, coming to your optionals first, forestry and agriculture. So, in forestry, can you tell me about what are the major edaphic factors for the growth of forest? What kind of soil is required?
Sorry, sir, I am not able to recollect.
Okay, fine. You have studied the silviculture of various species?
Yes, sir.
So, can you tell me something about sal? Silviculture of sal? What is silviculture, generally speaking?
The art and science of growing tree species.
Tree species, okay. So, there are various, methods. So you have heard about a method called shelterwood.
Yes.
Shelterwood method. Can you tell me what are the properties of shelterwood method?
Sir, I'm not able to repeat.
Okay. So justly, जहाँ हमारा syllabus रह अच्छी, ता ऊपर ऊपर टिके देखते हैं. ठीक है जी. अने जहाँ syllabus जो word टा अच्छी, से काम होगा ना थोड़ा दर. सिद्धि की समझ. Okay. So coming to agriculture, you see, what do you mean by integrated? Farming, what is the concept of integrated farming and how it can help our farmers?
Sir, integrated farming combines or integrates all the methods that is besides agriculture, dairy and poultry, etc. can be grown in a single place in an integrated manner while reducing the input cost for agriculture. So it can always increase the productivity as well as gives a better income to the farmer.
Okay. So you also know about in agriculture what are the major things which a farmer has to take care of when he is going for flood irrigation, and also tell me that according to you, which is the best form of irrigation for let's say cereals and pulses, various type of irrigation, you know.
Yes,
which irrigation would be best for them, for pulses and cereals? Okay. And what is the precaution farmer has to take when he using flood irrigation? You know what is flood irrigation?
Irrigating the total complete irrigating the field without any obstacles.
Without
it's called flood irrigation.
Yes. What are the dangers of flood irrigation?
It along with the crops, it also vexes the topsoil, that is the fertile soil. So the nutrient is lost from the current season. So there will be no potential for the upcoming season.
Okay. So, what type of irrigation will you recommend for cereals and pulses?
Sir, I believe check basin method of irrigation can be used effectively in cereals like paddy and pulses effectively.
Okay. And what is the reason for that? What? Just tell me what the features of this check basin irrigation which you are telling.
Sir, in check basin irrigation, bonds are created at a suitable interval so that water easily circulates among the field, and a drainage is located at the outside so that water can be easily drained to the other outside.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What is the main reason that many people who are in agriculture, okay, they are said to be in kind of disguised unemployment? Can you tell me the reason?
Sir, generally the farm, the cultivation of crops takes around 3 months. So, besides from the crops sowing season, there is not much work to do. So, during that the gap period, they can be employed anywhere, but they choose to stay in agriculture. That is called disguised unemployment. So it looks like they are working, but they are not actually contributing anything to the farming as well as to the economy.
Okay. So your specialization is agricultural economics, right? So can you tell me what is the problem with our agricultural loan system or agricultural finance? Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, there is not enough institutionalized credit available to the farmer. That's why they choose they become a victim of the money lenders who in turn grab their money. So it causes a hindrance to the agriculture production as well. And the farmer suicide is one of the reasons because of this.
So, what suggestions have you given that way? What steps the government has taken to institutionalize agricultural credit, and is this system, you know, has this system yielded benefit? And currently, what the government is planning to do in this case, so that the small farmer, marginal farmers, they can get loans. Okay, they can get money for the all the input costs.
So government has they can take loan from the cooperative credit society.
Mm-hmm.
As well as from the regional rural banks.
Mm-hmm.
And besides that, there is insurance for them called as Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, so that the adverse calamities won't hamper their won't be caused for their loss of life.
Mm-hmm. So, your knowledge of forestry and geography, how will that help you as an administrator? Let's say someone has taken public administration and law. Okay, why should I choose you and why shouldn't I choose him? Because administration, in administration, law is required. In administration also, your public administration knowledge of that is required. So, he has those two options. But your options, agriculture and forestry, so you tell me why agriculture and forestry, or what is the importance of knowledge of agriculture and forestry in a career in civil service, for a career in civil service?
Sir, agriculture is the backbone of our country. Around it depends on the all the sectors of the economy. So if agriculture is neglected, then automatically our economic condition will not be that much improved.
Mm-hmm.
So, agriculture knowledge is being an agriculture student, I can be easily identify what is the problems.
Mm-hmm.
And readily available solutions can be entailed to the policy making. And regarding forestry is generally the science. It uses the where are the trees to be afforested or reafforested. And the for combating the climate change, forestry helps a lot.
Okay, that is fine. So, as a student of agriculture, okay, what recommendation will you give to a farmer, you know, who stays in an arid land? Okay, so what crops should he grow in an arid climate?
Sir, in arid climate, generally millets can be grown, like corn millet, small millet, etc., which do not require much of water, and it also has nutritional value. For that, they can easily choose that.
So, your 10th standard in which school you have done?
Sir, I have done my 10th standard in Government High School, CRP Warangal.
Okay, in CRP Warangal. Right. And plus 2?
Sir, from BJB Junior College.
BJB Junior College. So, what was your percentage in 10th standard?
Sir, 92%.
92%. And in plus 2?
Sir, 80.86%.
80.86. Okay, so throughout career, you have a good career. So, generally students choose to go for engineering, medical, etc. Why did you choose for agriculture?
Sir, I have a 1 year gap. During that period, I have prepared for medical. I have took coaching for medical. But unfortunately, I could not get a seat on the government colleges.
Okay.
So I thought, hosting 1 year, I have already hosted 1 year. I have already known about the medical preparation. So I thought I can, besides reading agriculture, I will give a next attempt in
for the medical. So you joined. Okay, fine. No, 1 year you have studied, you have prepared. No, it's not wasted actually. You gain knowledge, right? So yeah, if you have given your time, it's not wasted. Okay, fine. So, which is your home district?
Sir, my home district is Cuttack.
Cuttack is your home
district. Banki, Cuttack.
Banki. So, can you tell me something about the history of Cuttack? What this word means, Cuttack?
Sir, Cuttack means fortification or
cantonment. Yes, correct. Who made the city or who laid the foundation of the city of Cuttack? Which king?
Sir, I'm not sure, but I can guess.
You can guess, yes.
Sir, Malkat Kesari.
Malkat Kesari. Okay. So be sure about that. Okay. Sometimes Cuttack is also called Abhinav Varanasi. Can you tell me why it is called Abhinav Varanasi Cuttack? It is another name given to Cuttack. Abhinav Varanasi.
No, sir.
It is because Varanasi, Banaras, is flanked by two rivers on both sides. Similarly, Cuttack is also flanked by two rivers on both sides. Okay. So. That is why it is called Abhinav Varanasi.
So is it Mahanadi?
Mahanadi and the Kachar. Two sides. Okay. So that is the thing. Okay. So why is Cuttack famous for?
Sir, Cuttack is famous for its silver filigree works.
Yes.
And secondly, it is famous for its cultural heritage like on fairs like Bali Yatra.
Mm-hmm.
And it is the industrial capital of Odisha.
Industrial capital of Odisha, okay. So, government of Odisha is slowly planning to take out all the important offices from Cuttack, which was old capital, to the present capital, Bhubaneswar. Being someone from Cuttack, what is your opinion? For example, our police headquarters is at Cuttack. In most of the states, police headquarters will be in this capital. So for administrative convenience, the government wants to bring all the important offices from Cuttack to Bhubaneswar. What is your opinion about it?
Sir, I believe as far as it is doing good for our economy and our governance, it does not matter. it is located, so it can be migrated to the urban nation.
It can be in the urban nation. Okay. Similarly, there is also a demand by people of different other parts of Odisha, like Western Odisha and all, to have a bench of the Odisha High Court. Because it is very difficult for someone to come to Cuttack always. Okay, we are traveling 300, 400, 500 kilometers. So, in that case also, what is your opinion? That we should have, the High Court should have benches in other parts also?
Yes, sir, I believe there should be a bench for the High Courts there as well, because they have to travel a lot and more expenses are being done on that front. So, it can reduce their expenses as well as they can get quality lawyers and judgments.
So, what is, you know, from the tourist point of view, you tell me three important places of Cuttack. Tourist point of view. Suppose I am someone who is coming from outside Odisha or outside India, and you are in charge of the tourism of Cuttack. What advice will you give me? I can only visit three places. So first, which place should I visit? Second, which place should I visit? Third, which place should I visit, and why?
Sir, there is a maritime. Sorry, sir, I'm not able to
recollect. Huh, but Seta, maritime museum is there. It has about a lot of things about the history, maritime history of Odisha. If you Bali Yatra rivers, it will both sit here also. Number one. Second, first you will tell Barabati Fort, because that is the main, you know, putting it on the dynasty that I'm going to say it here. So number one is Barabati Fort. Second is, so Barabati Fort is a historical, okay. এটা তারপরে সেটা কি আমরা কইলে মিউজিয়ামটা দ্যাট ইজ অলসো ফাইন সেটা ঠিক আছে ওকে সো দ্যাট ইজ দ্য সেকেন্ড থিং তারপরে বহু দূরে জায়গা আছে আপনার কইবেন কোটি কি আপনার তাকে
কাটা চান্ডি মন্দির
হ্যাঁ মেবি হি হ্যাজ কাম ফ্রম আউটসাইড হি মে নট বি ইন্টারেস্টেড ইন টেম্পল সো কাটা চান্ডি মন্দির ফ্রম দ্য রিলিজিয়াস পয়েন্ট অফ ভিউ ওয়ান অফ দ্য মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্ট প্লেসেস ওকে সো আদার প্লেস অলসো লট অফ প্লেসেস আর দ্যাট যেটা কি তার ইম্পর্টেন্স আপনি কইবেন আছে সেটা দেখে দেবে ঠিক আছে কি ওয়েবসাইটে আপনার ডিস্ট্রিক্ট সব ডিটেলস করে দিতে আছে ওকে ফাইন সো এনি টু গ্রেট পার্সোনালিটিস ফ্রম ইউর ডিস্ট্রিক্ট
স্যার মধুসূদন দাস এন্ড কবিবর রাজনাথ রায়
ওকে টেল মি দ্য কন্ট্রিবিউশন অফ দিস থ্রি দিস টু গ্রেট পিপল
স্যার মধুসূদন দাস ইজ দ্য ফার্স্ট বিএ এন্ড অলসো দ্য হি ইজ দ্য ফার্স্ট গ্রাজুয়েট অফ গ্রাজুয়েট এন্ড পোস্ট গ্রাজুয়েট ফ্রম ওড়িশা এন্ড হি ইজ এ He was a legislative member of the Bengal Bihar province, and he has founded Utkal Sammelani for the scattered for the unification of scattered Odia tracts. So, in the creation of Odisha state, he has a lot of contribution. And Rajanath Rai is known as the best of the poets.
Any composition or any poem of him that you know, name of any poem?
Sir, I'm not.
Okay. So, this is about your district. Okay, now let us come to some general questions. So, what is your preference of services for this exam? First, what you have taken?
So I have first preference. I have given OS.
Okay.
And then OPS.
Mm-hmm.
Then OFS.
Mm-hmm.
Then OCS.
Okay, fine. First three you pay. You have first OS, then OPS. So OS, tell me something about what is the rank structure of OS? How many ranks are there?
Sir, in the basic for the entry level, there are posts like video.
They are the posts, fine. And what about the ranks?
So there are five ranks.
Yes.
First is the junior grade, OS junior grade, and
then junior grade, senior grade,
then super, and then OS animation.
Super time scale,
in super annuation?
SAG, super administrative grade.
Then the principal,
special secretary.
Special secretary.
Okay, that's last one, highest for within the OS, that is special secretary.
Okay.
Any example of special secretary post that you can give?
So, officer on special duty to prime chief minister.
Official special, okay. OPSC special secretary is also there. Since OPSC is also conducting your exam, that also can say. Okay, fine. So, why you have taken OS as your first choice, although OFS and OPS are also group A service with the same perks and the salary?
Sir, is the job diversity that gives me immense opportunity to learn different aspects of the governance.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I have chosen OS.
Job diversity is there. Can you tell me why it is said that there is job diversity? Or what is the reason that you say that there is job diversity in OS?
So because of the different works by the different officers. Like the BDO takes care of the developmental works, while the Tahsildar takes consideration the law and order as well as the revenue in that tasks. While there are several other posts like one can be a secretary of, one can be PA, PAS. Someone can become Home Affairs chairman.
And PSU, huh? So many PSUs are there. Okay, fine, that is okay. So suppose like you are appointed as OS officer and there is a flood situation which is in your area, but the government immediately is not able to provide relief, okay, relief material. But government has told you that you get it from the local market, open market, whatever cost is there, after 1 month or something, government will repay the entire cost. Okay, so there is only one shop in your area which can give you that amount of ration. But the shop owner is saying that he will give only on 50% advance. 50% advance comes out to be, for example, your 2 months salary. You have the amount in your savings account. Okay, and this shopkeeper is saying that you give it from your account. Okay, and when the bill will be cleared by the government, he will return you back. Okay. So, what will you do in that case?
Sir, in this case, I will first persuade him that it is the calamity and the people should not be suffering from that. And if he does not take it into this consideration, then I will try to organize a crowdfunding so that the basic amenities of the people can be fulfilled at the earliest.
Crowdfunding? What is the meaning of the word, Mr. B? Crowdfunding?
Sir, crowdfunding means everyone, like other parts of the city or a village or in the country, they can provide some money, contribute to for this development, for this activity.
Okay. Fine. So, according to you, what are the three most important, many qualities are required, but three most important qualities that must be there in a civil servant?
Sir, first quality should be there is courage, second is integrity, and third is empathy for the people.
These three are there. Okay. What about efficiency? Suppose he has all three, what you said, but person is not efficient. He is not result oriented, he cannot deliver public service, then what will happen? But he has all the three, what you have said. Okay, he has empathy for the people. Okay, he is honest, right? He is upright, he is sincere, but he is not efficient.
Sir, for efficiency, you can train him for better train him in the government colleges so that he can learn. And I believe if one is integral to service and is empathetic, he will work on this.
Okay, fine. Fine, so that will be the end of the interview. Thank you.